just outside St. Paul.
Time to go watch the Seahawks.
The Cornelia Marie crew prepares for their first offload.
Good job, skipper.
Super Bowl down.
And a chance to catch the big game.
I like it. Let's go Seahawks.
St. Paul Harbor Master, Port Avery.
The harbor is going to be closer tonight. It's the morning. We got really high swells in our harbor right now.
Roger. Thank you.
Oh, my God.
This fucking sucks. I was told I can't enter the harbor. The swells are just beating the shit out of the boat against the docks. We are told to stand down for the time being and drop the anchor and wait for permission to enter. You don't want to end up on the beach.
We end up on the beach. Josh is fucked.
Hey, guys, start getting the anchor ready. They're not allowing us into the harbor.
You could potentially be out here for a couple days, easily. I don't know what the hell I'm gonna tell the guys. If we can't get into the dock for Super Bowl, they're gonna probably kill me.
Locked out of the harbor until morning, the swells have the Cornelia Marie dock blocked.
And we're gonna miss the Super Bowl because it's bullshit.
I'm gonna start panicking.
All I say is we better make that Seahawks game. I will throw on a survival suit and throw if I have to.
Just outside St. Paul, aboard the Cornelia Marie.
I got a boat full of football nuts rigging up a 2x12 over the side of the boat right now to make me walk the plank unless I can get them in there to watch the game.
Morning lights is coming out. I'm gonna go attempt to get in the harbor this morning. One way or another, we're making this.
Massive waves have kept the boat anchored outside the harbor.
A lot of power behind those waves, a lot of power. That's enough power to throw this boat onto the beach like a rag doll.
Security, security, security.
As day breaks, Captain Casey McManus radios for permission to enter.
Cornelia Marie, standing by 1673. Cornelia Marie. We'd like to come in. We're waiting to offload.
Yeah, Roger.
All right, we'll come see you, thanks.
All right, we got a place to tie up, guys. Super Bowl, here we come, baby.
Out of water, right here.
Getting permission was the easy part.
We got waves right now that are as tall as three-story houses.
Now, the skipper faces a gauntlet of breakers and rocks.
We end up on the rocks and we're all fucked. You know, puckers the butt a little bit. This is something that definitely a guy with experience has got to do.
These swells get under you, you get fucked up, you're done. But by the time they get in here, they break at about 20 to 22 feet tall. We have to time those because there's gaps in between the swells. So I'm going to come in here, I'm going to wait, and then I'm going to go for it. When you go for it, you got to hammer down and get into this little gap here. Otherwise, St. Paul is going to have a new drink, and it's going to be Cornelia Marie on the rocks.
20-foot swells sweep the harbor in sets. Casey has to shoot the gap between them, time it wrong, and the waves will slam the Cornelia Marie into the jetty.
Let this big set here pass, and then we're probably gonna have to go for it.
Comes the next one, right now.
Dude, you can see them right here, dude. They're coming right under us, man. It's fucking nuts.
And you got a big break.
With a break in the swells,
away we go.
Casey makes his move.
There's that 80-foot gap, huh?
That's that 80-foot wide gap right there.
much room do you have on either side of the boat?
Fuck it, I don't want to talk about it right now. This shit can go so sideways in here so fast.
Passing through the gap, the skipper turns hard toward the dock.
Perfectly. I mean, that doesn't get much better than that.
Seahawks!
We got her in. We've made our deadline.
After a 4-year battle, Josh Harris makes his first delivery as a boat owner.
What's up, Mr. Josh? How are you doing today? Good to see you again. Good to see you again with this boat.
Hey, let's go,
Seahawks! Yeah.